Hello. While working on a community, there could be scenarios where there is an external third party which is used as content management. For example, WordPress. So you might be writing your blogs in WordPress. Now, if you want it to get imported into Salesforce community and displayed on the community, to do that, we have to make use of CMS connection. It consists of three steps. Very first, we are going to have a connection between Salesforce and the CMS system. The CMS system could be AEM, could be Drupal, could be Google site, could be WordPress. Once we have done the connection, then we are going to drag and drop the CMS Connect JSON component on the community. And then we are going to set parameter on that component. So let's see this in action. Now, imagine we have got a website by name jacklyons.me. This is a real website. And you want to extract one of the blogs from this particular website and display it on your own community. To do that, all what we need to do is first we need to get a JSON object of everything. Now, WordPress provides a REST API with which you can extract all the posts of a WordPress site using a very simple URL, which is the site name jacklyons.me, and then this is the REST API endpoint and then posts. So now let's copy this entire thing and have a look at it, how it looks like in a JSON editor. Now, when we look into JSON editor, it tells me that the ID is 1502. Link is this, then title is this. So let's try to go to this particular link. Let's open it in a new tab. Now, our intention is to display this content on our community. So let's start doing that. So we'll go to Salesforce. Let's take, for example, we'll start with workspaces. Over here, we'll go to content management, and since we want to connect to an external third-party content management system, we'll first make connection. And I have already created a connection. Let me show it to you. So this is a name I just gave WP as a name. CMS source is WordPress. You can have AEM, Drupal, Sitecore, and others. Any content management which can return result in a JSON or in HTTP format can be connected to. So in our scenario, we have WordPress. Connection type is public. You can have an authenticated also if your content that you're trying to retrieve is behind the login firewall. URL is jacklyons.me, and then we have created the JSON as such. So we are saying we want to retrieve the ID and title and get it from this particular path. The name I have given is blog item. When you are going to create it for your own WordPress site, remember this ID and title should be the same as to what you see in your JSON editor. For example, I have got ID over here, which is in lowercase, and I also have got title. And this is the path WP JSON WP V2 post. If you just look into this and the URL that I showed to you, it's the same thing. And at the end, we are going to pass on. Since we want to display one particular blog from the entire list, we are going to pass on the ID of that blog. That is the reason we have component over here. Let's save this. And let's enable it also. Now let's go to our community. We'll go to builder. Let's drag and drop the CMS JSON component. So CMS connect, I'll just drag and drop over here because we want to display the blocks. Now it is asking me that select the CMS source. My CMS source is WP. Over there, if you remember, I created a content by name blog item. And in the path, which particular one I want to see. So I would say that I want to see ID 1502. So I'll just copy this and paste it over here. Just to reiterate what we are doing, we are setting up the connection and we are going to get the blog with ID 1502 onto our community. And the display, I want to get title, so I'll say @title, and this is where we are mapping to the JSON one. I'll just show it to you why I did title rendered. If I look at the JSON, we have got title and then we have got rendered, so that's why. The title render, and let's save it for the time being. We can also have body, we can have author published on. Let's save it. So let's publish this. Now this is what we are doing. So if you look over here, if I just preview this, this particular blog, lesson learned from building a full stack UI, is same as this is the heading over here, which is we are getting it live from a WordPress site. Now, if you just go back and try to get more content over here. Now, I also want to get the body. I'll say @content. Rendered. Let's cross check everything is correct in the JSON. I've got content, within content the render tag. Let's say save. Now it will give us an error because there are certain URLs which we have not whitelisted it. So if we go ahead and whitelist these URLs, then the data from these will also be displayed. But let's publish this. And preview now. Now this is the entire content which is coming from a live website. So this is the one. As a front-end developer, I've generally found it little. So this is the blog which is written on a website and we are getting the content over here. So as a front-end developer, the same thing. So if someone goes and changed the blog on the main site in CMS, in our CMS, in community, it will also get reflected. So just to reiterate, to display the external content, we first have to create a connection, then drag and drop the component and set the parameter. Thank you.